Welcome to Edo International News, where news and information about Edos worldwide arrive in one place simultaneously. My name is Osiri Yamu, and these are the March headlines. We're starting in Benin City, where APC creates election history. Over to London for more election spotlight as the Benin Union UK elects a new president. Staying in England, but up north Newcastle, where special prayers were held for Edo State at the 2019 Edo Prayer Conference and Seminar. Then it's over to Italy, where Miss Julie Idehe, whose organs were stolen in an Italian hospital in 2019, is asking the government and Nigerian High Commission for help. That and many more stories, including Dave Black, the new Edo superstar, Tony Kabaka's Lions, and why successful Edo women in diaspora should not be worried about importing husbands from back home. We'll be right back after the break. Edo International News is supported by Obaseki Solicitor. Straight into politics, where APC Edo State has created history by becoming the first party to win all 24 seats in the Edo State House of Assembly elections held March 9, 2019. The Edo State Governor, Godwin Obaseki, has expressed his gratitude to the voters' enthusiasm for his APC party, promising his administration is now turbocharged to exceed expectation for millions of Edos in developmental programs and policy. Still in Benin City and on Edo politics, and people are asking a question, is Edo State now exporting political thugs to other states for election? Akwa Ibom Police Commissioner Ibrahim Kauje has confirmed that nothing incriminating was found with the 153 thugs imported from Edo State to last week's election in Akwa Ibom. All the men have now been released pending further investigation. Well, it looks like the election fever in Benin City is getting too hot for APC chieftain, youth leader Mr. Tony Kabaka. He simply got some lions from the zoo to protect him during the election period. Well, now that APC has won, we hope Mr. Kabaka has taken the poor cubs back to their enclosure. Finally, on Nigerian politics, the EU observers of the Nigerian presidential elections held last month have given their report. In a press conference, The Voice TV about the election conduct, the EU observers announced their assessment, stating the environment was difficult with cases of lateness by INEC officials, violence, intimidation, vote buying, and underage voters across polling centers. And all these factors have compromised trust in the Nigerian voting process. They also said APC and PDP were to blame. However, they're just observers. INEC has now declared President Muhammadu Buhari of the APC party as the winner of that election. Over to London, and the Benin Union UK have elected a new president for the next 2 years. Mr. Joe Azaka was confirmed as the president of Benin Union on February 27, 2019. He has been inundated with goodwill messages from the Ajonwe Council of the UK and Ireland and many well-meaning Edos across the world. After a successful meeting between presidents of the three senatorial districts, Mr. Destiny Ebudage, president of Asan Voice, was also at the ceremony to congratulate Mr. Azaka.
I am the president. Okay, yeah, even I don't have a two saloba, a dead dude was the asset. You may now see a year and do ya cuckoo, or UK, King of America, King of Canada, King of Italy. You may do your royal affair at least once in a while. It will have here in my cuckoo.
Well, I'm Mr. Andrew Henry, just elected Vice President of Benin Union UK. Benin Union UK is a cultural organization where we come together as Benin-speaking people in the United Kingdom, and we deliberate on matters and issues that concerns us both here in the diaspora and back home in Nigeria. My role as a Vice President is to support the President, Mr. Joe Azaka.
Hi, my name is Destiny Ebudage. I am the president of Asan Voice Association UK. I came to pay a visit to the Benin Union today, just to let them know that we need to have a unity among ourselves and to come together as a body to help develop where we come from, which the Edo States.
Next stop is Newcastle, where Umagbai Nedo Prayer Ministry held the 2009 Prayer Conference and Seminar. The theme was Ukposa Bavutedu, meaning The Light of God Shine on Edo Light. The seminar was held on Friday, 23rd February 2019 at the Patchwork Project Building in Newcastle. The visionary is Evangelist Gladys Ogbede. Guest pastors included Pastor Monday Bude, Stella Ogbehan, and Minister Iyobo for Christ. There was business appearances from Barrister Jennifer Obaseki, Dr. Loretta Ogboroko. Here is Mr. Lamte Oriahi praying for Edo Land at the seminar.
For us to tell what is going to happen in the next minute. As we speak, election is going in Nigeria. As of this morning, about 25 deaths have been recorded and more than 500 injuries. Officially, unofficially, we don't know. It means that we are really in a difficult situation in our own national life. Let us pray for the peace of God to reign upon Nigeria as a nation. The peace of God.
Back to Europe, Italy, and Edo lady Julie Dehen Osamede, whose organs were stolen in an Italian hospital and left paralyzed in the process, is calling for assistance from the Nigerian High Commission, the federal government, and the state government. Mrs. Dehen said,
"Since 2009, I get fever when I take go hospital. I reach hospital, they do me tests for blood. They say I get a fever, say I know they feel sleep. They will give me something, make I take a sleep, make I take relax. Now I say, thank you. Then later in the evening, they give me food, I eat finish. They bring the thing, they put up for a waste cup. I say, make I put water. I put a drinker. Then I sleep off. Later in the night, as I sleep, I know if it turn myself. Now I can open my eyes, say, ah. What thing they happen to me? As I open my eyes, I see three people. One man, two women. Then they tie me for bed. The man tie me for right. The other woman tie me for the left. The other woman own injection. And how about the house, they say, ah, why not tie me for bed? And they say, make I keep quiet. Say they want to give me injection. I say, ah, which injection I want to give me? Doctor won't tell me so, I want to give me injection.
Over to Africa, where last month Ghana deported 723 Nigerians back to Nigeria. In what many are calling a revenge to the 1983 Nigerian deportation of Ghanaians, Ghana has deported 723 Nigerians, claiming they were internet fraudsters, prostitutes, and those lacking work permit to work in Ghana. The Nigerian High Commissioner to Ghana, Mr. Michael Abikoye, has stated the deportation as an improper act that could strain relationships between the two countries. Nigerian government also laments the fact that the deportees have been tortured and are making plans to start deporting people working in Nigeria without proper working permits. Common sense has got to prevail now. Stay with us for more Edo news, including our Edo special of the month, Edo entertainment, and our new segment, What the Blogs Are Saying. Edo International News is supported by Obaseki Solicitors. Welcome back to Edo International News, and we're live from London. Members of the Edo diaspora have called on the Edo state government to look at ways of rehabilitating the bronze structures across Edo state, which depicts our history. Following a recent documentary by Igodo TV showing most of the bronze structures in deteriorating state, the Edo diaspora are calling on the state government to intervene to help save a huge part of our great Benin Kingdom. These are historical assets with priceless history attached to them. The diaspora is also asking how they can get involved if asked by the government.
We can see we've been able to take a lot of pictures of notable statues around Benin City. We took pictures and video of exactly what is going on in Benin today. We've always been saying that Benin Kingdom is an ancient kingdom and the cradle of black civilization. It is in the prospect of that we realized that we needed to tell the world and the people in general that concept of cradle of black civilization is no longer in existence because of what we cannot see physically. We've seen some of the erected statues that are just 4 years old, how completely destroyed they are. We've seen pictures of obas latent with a lot of debts, as if we are in the kingdom of pigs. For some of us who are not aware, the place we now call King Square or Ring Road
Next is our Edo Special of the Month. Edo Special of the Month is supported by TotalAspirations.co.uk. On Edo Special of the Month, we're with the Unity Brothers Club, United Kingdom, formed 10 years ago. Edo Connect meets the current club president, Deacon Benson Asemota, who talks to us about the makeup of the Unity Brothers as a representation of the three senatorial districts that make up Edo State.
When I came in 3 years ago, I decided to come in to affect life and affect positively, and charity, they say, begin at home. And I decided that our regime should go back home and start affecting life positively. So I'm very proud to say today that we are affiliated to Edo Orphanage Home in Benin City, owned by Esther Ibe. And it has become an annual event for the club. So we spend reasonable amount of money every year into that orphanage home, and not even spending the money, we go there to spend quality time with those children. As fathers, we go there, we carry them, we bring them, we embrace them. That is what we do.
You're watching Edo International News. Coming up is our news segment, What the Blogs Are Saying. What the Blogs Are Saying is supported by Loretta Review. On this segment, we look at all what the 1,000,001 blogs are saying and pick what connects most to the Edo community. This month, we've picked the popular UK blogger Obodo Oyibo TV, and she's talking about why African women, including Edo women, should not be scared of importing a husband from Nigeria, simply because it works.
There's a lot of issues associated with bringing people here, whether it's a man bringing a woman or is a woman bringing a man, you know, it's associated with a few issues. But what I've seen is that the population of women, like we all know, it is disproportionate to the population of men. Like women that are seeking, you know, serious relationship. I'm talking about African women now in the diaspora. I can talk about here in the UK. I know it's the same in the US. So the population of African women in the US and in the UK here, who are looking for serious relationship and marriages, is higher, much higher than the population of men who are available.
Log on to our YouTube channel, Obodo Oyibo TV, to watch the full video. We're also encouraging Edo women to make videos that will keep us informative, and we will promote them. Next is our Edo Entertainment, and then the announcement. Edo Entertainment is supported by Obaseki Solicitors. On Edo Entertainment this month, it's safe to say Edos are winning in the UK music scene. David Omorige, aka Dave Black, and his new record, Black, is currently one of the hottest singles in the UK mainstream. He has amassed over 2 million views in less than a month, and is also featuring UK number one rapper Stormzy and Man City footballer Raheem Sterling in the video. Congratulations to Dave, and thank you for making us proud. We can't wait to support you. Next is UK comedian Osasieme Osazuwa, aka Don Nice, and he will be having his second edition of this UK head-to-head tour on the 5th of May 2019. The address is the Lewisham Village Retail Park, and Don Nice will be featuring great comedians from across the United Kingdom. Red carpet starts at 4 a.m. and the real event starts at 5 p.m. Tickets starts from £25. Edo Entertainment is supported by Obaseki Solicitors. Now for the announcements. The Uniben Alumni UK is inviting all alumni and well-wishers to the 2019 reunion on the weekend, Friday 26 July to Sunday 28 July 2019. The event will be held at the Copthorne Hotel, Sheffield, and the theme for this year is the role of the alumni in research and national development. For more information, contact the LOC chairperson, Pius Obo, on 07984-258-989. The family of Bello Osage announces the bowing out of their champion, Sir Apostle General Dr. Nafu Bello Osage JP, the Okagbe of the Oloke family worldwide. He was 90 years old. Service of Songs will be held on the 20th of April in New Jersey at the Imperial on Esther, 1714 Eastern Avenue, Somerset, New Jersey. Time is 2 p.m. to 8 p.m. Further arrangements, including the funeral mass and reception, will take place in Benin City from Thursday the 8th of May to Sunday the 12th of May 2019. Over in London, and Dr. Charles Omorodion and family would like to thank and appreciate all those who attended the service of songs for late Pa Ebowe held on the 23rd of February 2019 at the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, London. Edos in diaspora send their condolences to the family of the former governor of Edo State, Mr. Lucky Gbenedion, who lost his second son, Osayote Gbenedion, and his nephew, Esosa Onyemese, in a fatal accident in Texas on Saturday, February 16th. Also, this week marks 2 years since the passing of the two-time governor of the old Bende State, Dr. Samuel Ogbemudia. Edos in diaspora also send their condolences and support to the Ogbemudia family. Well, we'll leave you with a new level in London of how Nigerians complain about the Nigerian government to the Western world. Here it is. That's it this time on Edo International News, and thank you for staying with us. Goodbye and have a great week.